Davao del Norte's governor maintains no money was offered to encourage people to sign a signature campaign for charter change. Edwin Dubahib gave that assurance during the resumption of the Senate's probe into the alleged corruption and coercion in securing signatures for the initiative. The Senate Committee on Electoral Reforms, led by Senator Aimee Marcos, held the hearing in Davao City after Senator Ronald De La Rosa said several witnesses from the province would like to testify.
Gusto ko lang malaman, isang tanong lamang, kung inalokan ba sila ng pera o ayuda? Kasi kanina nabanggit mo na may pangako na magbibigay ng AIX o MAIP or cash for work. May nakatanggap ba ng pera o puro pangako lang?
Wala namang pera na sinabi, pero may sinabi na may darating na mga AIX program at saka tupad. Dulitupad program. So ang sinabi lang po na lahat na nakasign, ito pong beneficiary.
De La Rosa says they want to hold accountable those who took advantage of the people of Davao by promising them money and aid from the government.
If a person comes to believe the promises of another, but then later those promises turn out to be mere lies, it is never the fault of the one who believed. The Senate is more than ready to hold accountable all those who have done these evil deeds.
Mindanao, which is reeling from deadly floods. In Davao de Oro, at least six people were killed, including a 12-year-old girl who died in a landslide in the town of Maragusan. Six others were injured in the town of Nubataan. Officials continue to conduct clearing operations as many roads in the province remain impassable. Davao del Norte Representative Alan Dujali says around 100,000 families have been affected by the severe flooding, forcing many out of their homes. Dujali described the floods as the worst they have experienced yet.
Sa mga nakikinig naming mga kababayan, kami po ay nakikiusap dito sa Davao region kung may maibigay kayo na tulong, pagkain o anuman, baka pwedeng tulungan nyo naman kami dito kasi malaki talagang problema ang inaharap namin ngayon dahil sa dulot ng baha. Hindi pa kami nakarecover sa baha 2 weeks ago, eh ngayon, baha na naman. Sobrang lalim ng baha ngayon kaya kailangan talaga namin ang tulong, kahit anong tulong na pwedeng ipadala dito sa Davao region.
Philippine Senator De La Rosa sees politics behind efforts to link the Duterte family to drugs and extrajudicial killings. De La Rosa, who was a former chief of police in Davao City, challenged retired police officer Antonio Lascanias to offer proof to back his allegations. The senator vows to reveal those he believes orchestrated the allegations against the Dutertes and their allies.
Nagkakataon lang ba ito? Kung kailan ito uminit yung issue about PI, pinalabas na naman na si Las Cañas. Ano ito? The people behind the Las Cañas ay nakakunik na naman sa people behind the PI? O napakalaking, ano, napakalaking coincidence.
The Philippine government is urged by a visiting United Nations Special Rapporteur to abolish its controversial anti-insurgency task force. Irene Khan spoke to the media Friday at the conclusion of her visit to the Philippines. The Special Rapporteur on Freedom of Opinion and Expression says the NTF-LCAC should be dissolved after it linked several personalities to the armed movement. Khan was in the country for weeks where she spoke to activists and government officials. She now urges government to continue making reforms to improve the country's rights situation.
There is clear evidence that red tagging and terror tagging are being practiced by security forces as part of their counterterrorism strategy. It intimidates and chills freedom of expression. It suppresses legal activism. It isolates and antagonizes those who are unfairly attacked, puts them in a vulnerable position, and undermines public trust in civil society and the media. There is an expectation that the government will build on the steps it has already taken to make more significant legal, policy, and institutional changes. And it is only by doing that it will reaffirm the image of the Philippines as a forward-looking, vibrant democracy committed to human rights and the rule of law.
The Philippine National Security Council, meanwhile, opposes Khan's recommendations, at least for now. It says plans are underway to eventually transition the NTF-ELCAC to a peace and development body.
Once the 11 remaining guerrilla fronts have been dismantled, then that will be the signal to transition to the National Task Force for Unity, Peace and Development. The other thing, perhaps, is once a political settlement has been signed with the CPP, NPA, NDF, then that would require the transition of NTF-ELCAC to a body dedicated to unity, peace, and development.
Philippine progressive lawmakers welcome UN Rapporteur Khan's call to abolish the NTF-ELCAC. The three-member Makabayan bloc has been the subject of red-tagging by the task force. One of its members, Congresswoman Franz Castro, urges President Marcos to heed the recommendation, and Rights Group Karapatan also thanked Khan for the release of her findings. It says the results are consistent with the situation faced by journalists, activists, and ordinary people on the ground. The Armed Forces of the Philippines says it has conducted another successful resupply mission to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre in the Ayungin Shoal on Friday. AFP spokesperson Colonel Francel Padilla notes it was a flawless rotation and resupply operation for the Armed Forces. Meanwhile, National Security Council Assistant Director General Jonathan Malaya says they did not notify and will never notify China when it comes to any resupply mission by the Philippines. He adds no amount of pressure from China will change the country's position.